Hello all, let us see esterification today. Esterification is basically a process whereby alcohols react with carboxylic acids in presence of a few drops of either concentrated sulfuric acid or dry HCl gas, right? So this particular reaction is very slow reaction since it is a reversible reaction, right? And there are two versions to this esterification. If we use concentrated sulfuric acid, then it is called as a normal esterification as such. And if instead of this, if you take help of dry HCl gas for the esterification to proceed, then that is called as Fischer-Speyer esterification. Okay. So as we can see in the form of a reaction, carboxylic acid, RCOOH interacting with an alcohol in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid, water molecule will be eliminated from here and you will be getting your ester. Okay. Similarly, take one more example. Say if I take ethanoic acid, so it is CH3COOH. Further, if this interacts with ethanol, HOCH2CH3. What is going to happen? Again, the same process you have to understand. There will be a loss of water molecule in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid and there will be a formation of an ester. So, CH3COOCH2CH3. That is the formation of ethyl ethanoate will take place. Okay. Now, let us move to the mechanism of this particular reaction. The mechanism process will start with one of your reactant, that is carboxylic acid. So when your carboxylic acid comes under the interaction of the mineral acid which you are taking, it can be in the form of a concentrated sulfuric acid or dry HCl gas which maybe you are using, right? So protonation of the carboxylic acid in the first step will take place. So protonation, say, takes place at this oxygen atom. As a result of this, protonated carboxylic acid is formed. Okay. Now further, this protonated carboxylic acid will have tendency to result in the formation of an electron deficient carbonyl carbon, right? How it is going to take place? This is an hydroxyl group which is having electron deficiency. So this oxygen will pull the electrons towards itself. As a result, carbon will develop a positive charge, right? It will be deficient in electrons now. Then in the next step, there will be further attack of alcohol, which is your second reactant used within the esterification process. Now within this particular step, what is going to happen? Alcohol, due to its interaction of the oxygen, it is going to attack on this carbon atom, resulting in a formation of this particular intermediate. This intermediate is a tetrahedral intermediate, isn't it? Because as we can see, the central carbon atom is surrounded by four atoms or four groups bounded on either sides, bounded on the four sides. So there is the formation of this tetrahedral intermediate. Now this tetrahedral intermediate will be further converted into another form of tetrahedral intermediate. In what ways it is going to move out? See, this proton which is present here, oxygen being positively charged, it will pull the electrons, the bounded pair of electrons towards itself, hydrogen will be released from here and this hydrogen will further go and interact with this hydroxyl group, resulting in the formation of an OH2. But however, oxygen has shared its lone pair of electron to interact with the proton, so oxygen will develop a positive charge here, right, resulting in a second form of an tetrahedral intermediate. Then in the final step, there will be a loss of water molecule. This oxygen will pull the electrons towards itself. There will be a bond breaking taking place here and resulting in the formation of carbon positively charged, right? Now this electron deficient carbon will have next tendency to fulfill its electrons. From where it's going to get its electrons? See, the oxygen here has two lone pair of electrons. So it will pull the electrons here, resulting in the formation of double bond. But again, oxygen has shared its electron pair, so there will be a positive charge developed around oxygen atom. Again, the next step, the final step, oxygen has to regain its electron. So from where it is going to regain its electron, it will pull the electrons from this bonding pair, release hydrogen from here, right? So deprotonation will take place in a final step, resulting in the formation of ester. Okay, so that's about the mechanism of esterification. Okay, now following this, we'll see what is the relative reactivities of the carboxylic acid and alcohols which are being used within this process. So let us see that. As we saw within the mechanism of esterification, that there is a formation of tetrahedral intermediate as shown on the screen here, right? So it is very much clear from the vision of the tetrahedral intermediate that during esterification, if such intermediate formation has to take place, then the rate of esterification will definitely be sensitive to steric hindrance. That means, as the number and size of the substituents around the carboxylic group or the hydroxyl group of the alcohol, it increases, the rate of esterification is going to slow down, right? So on the basis of that, I can say the order of reactivity for carboxylic acids. So least steric hindrance, formic acid, right? So rate of reactivity will be highest for this, followed by acetic acid, right? Similarly, as you move on the higher sides, more the alkyl groups here, right? And this is a tertiary group which I attached to the acetic acid group, right? So in that case, I can say more is the number of alkyl groups. That means as the size of the substituents around the carboxylic acid is going on increasing, definitely steric hindrance will increase, because of which rate of esterification is going to move down. Similarly, you can consider for alcohols. In case of alcohols, again, if I have a methyl group, then steric hindrance is minimum. So it is going to proceed very smoothly. Rate of esterification is high. However, if the size goes on increasing, like here it is ethyl group, right? Suppose the size is going on still increasing, isopropyl group, tertiary butyl group, right? So as the size goes on increasing, or as the number of atoms, the number of substituents around the group increases, definitely steric hindrance is going to increase and the rate of reaction will slow down. Okay, so that is about the relative reactivity of carboxylic acids and alcohols in case of esterification. So that's for today. Thank you for watching.